Now, the registered dealer, I am a regular dealer, I can sell to a composite dealer, correct? So I will upload all my outward supply in GSTR 1. On the third month, which means now this is April, May, June, July 10th, what I have uploaded in the month of April, what I have uploaded in the month of May, what I have uploaded in the month of June, all three invoices, 3,345 invoices is going to come to you for composition dealer. So somebody has to go and take. Okay. It's going to be time consuming, right? So composition is also, life is not going to be easy under a composition scheme. So you have this quarterly return where the composition dealer first is that, you know, he is going to get all the details of all the inward supply for him, okay, for that particular quarter where all the registered dealers have filed the GSTR 1. Are you able to relate it? Okay, so he is going to get it. Now in case that very intelligent registered dealer would have thought, ಹೆಂಗೂ ಕಾಂಪೋಸಿಷನ್ ಅವ್ನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀನಿ, ಅವನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಡೀಟೇಲ್ ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ, ಏನು ಕೊಡಲ್ಲ, ಆ ಬಿಲ್ ತೆಗ್ದಾಕ್ ಬಿಡೋಣ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಲಯಬಿಲಿಟಿ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್ ಡೌನ್. ಇವ್ರು ತೆಗ್ದಾಕ್ತಾರೆ 10ನೇ ತಾರೀಕು ಜುಲೈಗೆ ಇವ್ರು ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ, ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಿಡಿತಾರೆ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬೇಸಿ ಸಿ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಐ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್. ಲಿಟ್ರಲಿ your every assessable value to the tax amount and assessable value to the tax amount has to be matched. And government is very intelligent. It says the outward supply dealer is saying 10,000 rupees is the assessable value and 1,000 rupees is the GST. Just take an example. Now the inward supply guy is filing on 15th. Now he will say 10,000 rupees is the assessable value, 900 rupees is the input value. So it is not matching. Government says no problem, I will accept. Why? 100 rupees government is gaining, right? Other way round, you have 4 forms to say why it is wrong. Okay, so that is the work, or that is the competency that everybody should have under GST. I'm not scary. We are there, so we don't have to worry. Then, for the composition tax dealer, this is GSTR 9A, which is the annual return. Then, just for our information sake, then foreign non-resident taxpayer. So, every foreign non-resident taxpayer has to compulsorily register. There is no threshold limit for him, and he will have to file his return on a monthly basis in GSTR 5. Then comes your input service distributor. So under the current regime, under service tax and excise, you have input ISD. So the same ISD is applicable under GST also, right? So input tax service distributor is going to provide monthly return. Basically the GSTR 6 is what is going to be his monthly return. And 6A, see, all this A is correction, reconciliation. All the A is reconciliation. Even though it is reconciliation, it is going to be time consuming because somebody has to check that and then say it is okay. Why? Because these are something which is new. I have to start believing this, right? When let us take a scenario. So these are all human psychology, right? We take a scenario where for the first time you started using calculator. Forget computer. You started using calculator. Before that, what were we doing? Manual. And we were all experts in totaling, right? And when I was doing my article, I was with one of the chartered accountant company. First 1 week when I went and joined and took my article, they gave me the telephone directory. The telephone directory, and said every page you keep totaling every day, and I want to see how many page you are totaling. Correct? So that was the thing. So you will have to do it fast thing. Now you got your calculator now. So you will use the calculator. You will get the answer. You will write the answer. Now will you believe your answer? First time, what would you do? So what will you recheck? Because at that point of time, there was no recheck in the calculator. Manually you will do. So 2-3 times you will do, and then you will now start believing the calculator. Today if I ask to do it on a calculator, I mean manually, என்ன உச்சிடுது என்று கால்குலேட்டர். தட் இஸ் வை ஆல் அவர் மொபைல், வெதர் தெர் இஸ் கால் ஃபெசிலிட்டி ஆர் நோ, எஸ்எம்எஸ் ஃபெசிலிட்டி ஆர் நோ, கால்குலேட்டர் இஸ் தேர். ஓகே, ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஃபார் தி இன்புட் சர்வீஸ் டிஸ்ட்ரிபியூட்டர். தென் தி டாக்ஸ் டிடக்டர், டாக்ஸ் டிடக்டர் இஸ் பேசிக்கலி தி கவர்மெண்ட். வென் கவர்மெண்ட் இஸ் டீலிங் வித் வேரியஸ் டாக்ஸபிள் டீலர்ஸ், தி கவர்மெண்ட் இஸ் கோயிங் டு டிடக்ட் டாக்ஸ், டிடிஎஸ் இஸ் கோயிங் டு பி டிடக்டட். Input service. See, this is not services distributor. It is service. This thing. Okay. Then the TDS is basically is the GSTR-7 is the monthly return that is going to think. Then, very, very important. Today, if you see the controls over e-commerce and the aggregators. So, aggregators is your Ola and Uber. See, there are no proper control over the tax element of control by the department, right? That's the loophole that currently we have. Now, there are specific sections and there are specific forms where the e-commerce person and the aggregator, which is your, which is a branded aggregator. Now, when you sell or supply the goods to e-commerce, right, and when he is going to make the payment, he is going to collect tax, TCS, tax collected at source on your behalf, and then he has to now submit it to the government, so that you know your tax invoice goes to your VAT form 100, but your internet invoice goes to your number 2 book, right? So no more escape, right? So everything is going to go into your thing, right? So the e-commerce, these are the form, monthly return form. Form GSTR-8 is what that they will submit 10th of the succeeding month. So then this is the aggregator which I am talking about, the Ola or the Uber, Meru and all those people, right? So they have this form 9B which they have to submit on a monthly basis 10th of the subsequent month. Okay, then final returns. What is final return? When the dealer is surrendering the registration or is being asked by the government to cancel, or the government cancels his registration, okay, then within the prescribed time, within 3 months from the date of surrendering of the registration form or cancellation of the order, you have to now file final return, right? You have to file. This is like in most of the Christian funeral we must have seen, right? Right, after that person dies, you know, they talk about this person, right? So once the business dies in GST, and this is what you will tell the government, saying that this is my final return. Okay, government department and United Nations. So basically, I mean, like today you have this exemptions, right, for this United Nations and all those things. So for them, you know, they have something called as UIN, unique identification number. They are going to provide a unique identification number so that they can opt for any two of it. Either they can give the unique identification number and tell the supplying dealer, saying that don't charge GST because I have this eligibility, or they can pay the tax and ask for refund, which is again more or less what is applicable today under the current law. Okay, so now we were talking about this 1A, 2A, 4A and all those things, right? So this is what is basically called as GST ITC. Okay, ITC is input tax credit form, so which is your matching. So now section 29 and 29A under GST law talks about how you can now, you know, match this. I mean, how can you now, you know, I mean, like, you know, do this matching and then say whether, you know, whether you are eligible for input tax credit right? And if you are not eligible now at a later stage, because you know in 3 days window period or in 5 days window period, you cannot go and resolve the dispute. That's not practical. So you have this 2-3 months time they have given. So based on that, you will now get all those things. So we will also talk about the most serious thing about the input tax credit, how the input tax credit eligibility will be made available for a dealer under GST. We will see that. Right. So first is this. This is just for your information. Again, these are all the new things that has happened day before yesterday. Right. Communication of acceptance, discrepancy, or duplicate of input tax credit claim. All this information will now come under that template. The template is already available. You have to go through this template. You have to understand what is the connection between 1A, 2A, 2, 3. At least for the regular dealer, I'm talking about. And you will have to establish this connection, and you should be very clear that yes, all these things, how this ITC 1 is going to do, ITC 1, 1A, 1B, 1C, how this is going to, you know, finally you have to link it. Otherwise, tomorrow your client is going to say, sir, I'll come to that ITC part, then we will know. You know, probably tomorrow my client might put gun on my head and say that, what did you do? If government is not giving me the money, you better give me the money. And if fees collect madodakinta ni fees avaru kodbeku. Okay, that's going to be this scenario, right? So next is that, okay, these are the sub forms which are there. Okay, ITC 1A is basically, it talks about the mismatch reported by the recipient, which means the purchasing dealer. ITC 1B talks about mismatch reported by the supplier, selling dealer, right? And then this is going to be the mismatch reported by the e-commerce operator. Okay, because they have to deduct TDS, TCS, right? They have to collect tax at source. So this is one new thing, very important thing for us to understand and see what is going to be the implication. See, when you see from the point of implication, two things you have to remember. How much time you are going to spend on this, and how are you going to educate your client such that you can save your time? Right? Yes, now we will just see the input tax credit mechanism. Very important. Please ask me if you have any doubt, any clarification. Very, very important. Input tax credit mechanism. So what is going to happen in input tax credit mechanism? There are broadly three conditions. What is that condition? Now, Mr. Arvind is a supplier. He is supplying to me, so which means let's understand from the current tax situation. So he is selling to me, right? So he sold me 10,000 rupees worth of goods. 1,000 rupees is the tax. So for him, 10,000 is the assessable value and 1,000 rupees as output VAT. Let's not worry about his input adjustment and all those things. We'll have to worry about me, right? So now I have purchased from him. What is this for me? Input. What is the ITC eligibility for me? 1,000. Now I am adding some 200 rupees on that, 2,000 rupees, and then selling it for 12,000 rupees, and I am collecting 1,200 rupees. In today's scenario, what is my tax liability? 200 rupees, right? Going forward, that is not permanent tax credit, or that is not going to be a permanent liability. Why? Condition number one. He has to now submit his sales in which form? GST. GSTR 1. On when is he submitting? Now I am going to get the visibility of this form from 11th to 15th. Now I will now see, now he will tell me, we will take only one simple case, let's not complicate too much. Now when I see on 11th in my portal, his sale will come to me in GSTR 2A as this is your purchase from Arvind, right? Now I will now have to accept it. Let's say it's a very simple case, only one transaction, now I'm accepting it. Very good, problem solved, right? Now can I get this 1,000 rupees input tax credit? Maybe. No, yes. Okay, what is condition number two? Condition number two is that on 20th, he has to file the return. File the return means he has to accept. Because you know it is going to come, the return is going to come. GSTR 3 is going to come on your portal. So you will have to accept it. Can I get input tax credit now? Maybe, maybe. Right? Now, he has to pay his, let us take the same example that for him it is 1000 rupees and his inward is 800 rupees. So, his tax liability is how much? 200. Now, until and unless he doesn't pay this 200 rupees, this is what the current law is, and this is where we from Tally on behalf of businessmen, the business houses, the especially the SME segment, and on behalf of all the tax professionals, we are taking this recommendation. In fact, you know, I had my CFO, Mr. Satya Pramod, who was sitting here, I think probably is gone out. Right, so he is leading. Basically what we are doing is we are trying to lobby the government and saying that this is going to be a nightmare for dealers. Small dealers are gone because, you know, the cash flow is at really, really stake. Okay, because, you know, he is not paid his 200 rupees liability, I am not going to get this 1000 rupees. So yes, okay, now yes, I will get it. How will I get it? I will get it as provisional. Which means he uploads GSTR 1, I upload my GSTR 2, it is matching, then I am eligible for provisional ITC, right? And I can pay also. But tomorrow, if there is one more bill which is not uploaded, I have uploaded, and he is disputing saying that no, I did not sell to you, for example, let us say. One is that I have already paid this input tax to him, cash flow out, there is a dispute, he is not accepting it, or next month he is not filed his return on time, he did not pay his liability on time. He is a nice person, but then I am just giving an example. Okay, so he is not paid on time, right? So now, if because of this, now my input tax credit is gone. And in the previous month, because I am taking provisional ITC, in the previous month, I cannot go and call every dealer saying, "Yena pa, you return file mardiya." Just imagine, just visualize the scenario, what is going to happen. Right? Yes, sir? And see, one good thing, the light at the end of the tunnel is everything is going to be systematic, everything is going to be technology driven. You should be prepared for it. And if GST gets implemented and the Karnataka government forgets, then you are lucky. That will be there. Whatever money should go to the government, even if you die, that's why they say legal heir is also bounded. In the application you will have to give, right? They will never leave. Okay. Yes. See, some state, in fact, if you see Maharashtra recently, they have introduced this kind of a system. Tamil Nadu have introduced this 29 annexures. All this is purely saying that, you know, and some of the state, they have amended the Input Tax Credit Eligibility Act, and they have amended the rule saying that until and unless the liability of the seller is not discharged, the buying dealer will not be eligible for ITC. This is, you know, in one, two state is there, and it is not seriously being implemented. Right? Today this is glaring straight on our face, which is very important. Okay? So, you have broadly understood this. So now we will just take this flow. So you have this buyer is who? Inward supply dealer. Right? Supplier is who? Outward supply dealer. Right? So now there are two broad conditions. What are the two broad conditions? One is that you should have tax invoice, and you should have received the goods. There are other small conditions, so it's not very, very critical. So that's why I'm ignoring all those, you know, nuances. But so broadly, if these two things are there, right? So on 10th, I'll just read this out. On 10th, this outward supply dealer is going to file GSTR 1 on 10th. What is this information that is going to give? Outward supply. Right, so he is now giving it on 10th. So where is he going to do? It is actually, he will now push it into the portal, which means he'll upload. Right. So now it goes to the GSTL portal. Now from 11th onwards, this person's, okay, all the sale from 11th onwards, if the sale is related to me, from 11th onwards, now I will get this sale information in GSTR2. So I have time till 11th to 15th to reconcile, accept it, right? So now this will come to, this visibility will come to me now on 11th, right? So now I go through those things. If there is anything missing, if everything is okay, I'll accept this 2A, which is your 2. If there is anything, then I will go and make those changes, right? And now I will on 15th, I will be submitting my GSTR2 to the GSTL portal, right? Now, the moment this has happened, I am now eligible for provisional ITC credit, right? Now, you people want a 5-minute break? Yeah, because it's very important. I can understand your mind can observe only what your seat can endure. So let's have a 5-minute break. So now, once this buying dealer files GSTR 2, right, that if there is any missing information in that GSTR 2 is what will now go as GSTR 1A to him, saying that you did not declare the sale, this guy is declaring the purchase, please solve the problem. That is what is going to happen here, right? So now from 16th to 20th, you have this window period where you will now resolve it, right? Match, do this thing, reconcile, resolve and all those things. If it is still not resolved, the law says that, you know, you have till the next end of the next tax period, you can resolve it, and then you can take input tax credit without any interest. Otherwise, if you have taken the input tax credit on provisional basis, and if it is not getting beyond the specified period, if it is not getting resolved, number one, you have to pay back that money what you have taken as input tax credit in total plus interest applicable, right? So it is double hit on the cash flow. One, I already paid my supplier and that guy vanished, right? Now I have taken input tax credit, he did not clear the liability, my problem is not solved. Whatever ITC I have claimed in the previous period as provisional ITC, now since it is not, the dispute is not getting resolved within the specified period of time, I have to now repay that money along with interest. Okay. Now, once this is done, on 20th of May, GSTR 3 is ready. Right. So now, the GSTR 3 is now visible to the supplier. Now he will now make the payment. He will now make the payment along with the liability that has been specified in the return. He has to do that, and then he has to now file the return. Once he files the return, now this person is now eligible for input tax credit. That means, you know, that provisional is gone. Now I can actually sleep peacefully at night, right? So now, how do you get this? You get this in GSTR ITC form number 1, which we were talking about ITC form. This is the electronic information that you get saying that you are now input tax credit, you are eligible for it, there is no dispute, right? He paid the 1,000 rupees, I have collected the 1,200 rupees, I paid my 2,000 rupees, so my problem is solved because he is complying to the law. I get the 1,000 rupees, that credit I am going to get. This goes into the electronic credit ledger. Okay. What is the flip side of it? This person, right, Arvind, he's not filed the return, right? Or he's filed the return, but he's not paid the liability. that return is supposed to be considered as incomplete return and non-compliance of filing of return as per the specified date. Right. So now he is not filed the return and he has not made the payment. He is defaulted for that particular month. Now he will not get the input tax credit that he has claimed if he is not filing the return on time and not paying the liability on time. So if you take this whole thing, suddenly I am remembering this hypothesis, or I mean it's an anecdote. I am able to remember this anecdote. So how do you see this GST from the government's point of view? Okay. Now if I ask all of you here, do you want to be a hunter or a fisher? What would you be? What would you want to be? I am asking all of you. Hunter. Right? How many hunters can I see the hand? How many hunters? That's all? How many fishers? Only one. Rest of you don't want to do anything in life. Right? Generally, what is that you would want to do? You want to do? I mean, you want to hunt, right? Why do you want to hunt? Revenue. That is only if you catch the target. You basically have thrill in life, right? You are running, catching, and then gundus irukano. Sorry, ladies. Right? Right? So that is what you get. Right? And this is exactly what our government was doing for the last 70 years. The poor government was running behind all the dealers saying that claim proper input tax credit, file your returns on time, match your input output, right? Reverse your ITC if you are not eligible. On URD purchase, pay purchase tax. We were not listening. Right? Now what does a fisher do? What does a fisher do? So what does he do? Right? See, he is going to sit comfortably like all of you in the chair, right? Take the fishing pole, put the bait in the hook, throw it in the water and wait for the target. Now when you are hunting, you run behind the target. Government got fed up. Now government has become fisher. Now target is running behind the fisher. This is exactly what, if you see this, you will get an understanding. He says, I will register you, you sell, you buy, you pay me, you will get input tax. He doesn't pay you, you don't get input tax. Now, the buying fish, the selling fish, every fish should reconcile and then go to the bait. That is what is GST today. Right? And government is very, very, they are fishing. In GST, government is fishing. You take all the pain. When I say you, most of the pain generally you people take. As tax consultant, right? Client is going to say, "Nee vidira sir, namge en ide sir. Nimge ella gottide sir. Neeve maadbidi." Right? Now the payment part. So okay. So the payment has to be made on 20th of the subsequent month. Right? And it is going to be, and I think Karnataka also we have some mandatory e-payment, right? 10,000 and above. Yeah? Yeah. Same thing. So if it is 10,000 and above, it is mandatory e-payment, and the e-payment can be done through NEFT, RGST, IMPS, and there are a lot of other things. People were asking swipe and all those things. You can pay through debit card, credit card, all those things. Maybe, you know, I mean, like, you know, the government, see, because this is going to be very, very huge. When I'm talking about the technology, I will tell you what is the magnitude of this technology backbone that the government is going to, you know, government is getting, you know, getting prepared for. We will discuss about that. So online, all these things can be done. And if it is less than 10,000 rupees, any of challan is going to be made available on your portal. Just download and then you can now make the payment. You can issue cash, check, DD, whatever is there. Now quickly we will run through inference with the current law. Right? Composition scheme. See, this is only for us to just get little consolation, saying that okay, GST is not everything new. There is something which is already I know, is going to be in GST. So composition levy, it is there today, it is going to be there in GST, right? And the composition levy also is going to be the same thing. When the current the draft law says that the tax liability of the composition will not be less than 1%. Now it could be 1%, it could be 5%, it could be 8%, we don't know. So GST council is going to decide. Okay, then you have this reverse charge mechanism currently under service tax. The same reverse charge mechanism is going to be applicable under GST. Only thing is, now probably the reverse charge mechanism could be applicable for supply of goods also. Now this is what I was talking about, as will be notified or as will be prescribed later. So one of the section says very clearly that the reverse charge mechanism is going to be applicable for services. Definitely it is going to be applicable for services, and also it is going to be applicable for goods also. Now what is going to be the list of services for which reverse charge mechanism is going to applicable? Today in service tax we know there are 8-10 services which reverse charge is applicable, but today we don't know what is the reverse charge is going to be applicable for goods, right? So they will now give the list, they will publish the list saying that okay, these are the goods for which reverse charge mechanism is going to be applicable. More or less the reverse charge mechanism is as what we are currently following. Exemption, the GST says very clearly there is not going to be any exemptions, there is not going to be any forms, nothing. But still, this is like contingency reserve. So there is section 10 which talks about the GST. The law says that yes, the GST council will have power in case tomorrow if I have to extend exemption conditionally or unconditionally, partially or fully, right, with the recommendation of the GST council, probably exemptions could be made available under GST. But today under GST, no exemption. Okay, remission of tax, this is mostly related to the product, we know, which gets this evaporated and all. This is excise related, ditto. Whatever is there under excise is going to be applicable under GST. Captive consumption, which is part of my excise today, is going to be applicable under GST. Reversal of ITC, yes, there is a section, there are nearly about 6 sections which talks about ITC claim and what are the reversal, when the GST dealer will be eligible for ITC credit and when he is not eligible. This is before he and me paying, right? So there is ITC reversal also under GST, which specifies there are various sections, subsection and clauses which says under what condition you will have to now reverse your ITC credit. Input service distributor, whatever is applicable today more or less is the same thing that is going to be applicable under GST. Job work, makki ka makki, whatever is the job work provisions which is there currently under excise is going to be applicable under GST. Tax credit on input stock held, right? So transitioning thing, right? So during VAT, and definitely we would have experienced during VAT, like, you know, what is the kind of nightmare you would have gone through, your clients would have gone through to claim the input tax credit. And some of them would have said, hey, bidri sir, 5000 rupees or input tax claim madadike nimge 5000 rupees kodbeku, hogri sir beda, right? There are scenarios. And after you have claimed also, you will have to wait. You know, the department is going to ask a lot of detail. You give me this detail, how is this, what is this purchase, the party name and all those things. Even here, there are 141 to 162, which is 21, 22, there are 29 sections under GST which is talking about transition provision. Very important, you people have to go through this, because this is where you will show that you are the champions of GST in front of your client. Very, very important. Okay, so tax credit on input tax credit is available. Somebody was asking non-filing or late filing, right? So late filing, 100 rupees per day for every day during which you fail to submit the return, and the maximum amount is 5000 rupees. Now somebody can think, okay, 100 rupees, I know, vidda pa magana na. But if you keep defaulting for 6 months, right? If you keep defaulting for 6 months, if you don't file your return for 6 months, then your registration is revoked. Okay, they will cancel your registration. Okay, so that is the late filing thing. Then delayed in interest tax, delayed in tax payment. Then the currently the rate of interest is not been specified yet, so we will get to know about it. And then we also have penalties. Okay, penalties, and you also have prosecutions. All right, so what are the penalties and prosecutions? If you see, up to 10,000 rupees or equivalent amount of the extent of the amount that tax has been evaded. Whatever we do today, IDS finance minister is worried. It is not successful, right? Tomorrow is the last date. The expected revenue under IDS is not coming, right? But this is GST technology driven. Be careful, it is going to come. Okay, so the penalty is going to be to this extent, and also there is imprisonment, which is prosecution, where it says if there is a slab, they have provided a slab between 25 lakh to 50 lakh, 50 lakh to 250 lakh, 250 lakh to 500 lakh or 500 and above, right? Between these three things, I mean, like, apart from the penalty, you will have imprisonment ranging from 1 year to 5 year, 1 year, 3 year, 5 year. If somebody wants to take holiday, probably you can recommend your client. Okay, very important. Anyway, I'm not going to tell in detail because this is all your job. In any case, you will have to read it. I'm just giving you a hint. Right? So I don't have to spend much time here. So one very good thing. See, I'm part of this sales tax group, WhatsApp group. Right? So I got a message that, you know, you people had a recommendation to the finance minister asking that, you know, the tax consultant should be part of the STRP, right? So now, while reading this law, if you read this law, all of you will know, after dinner you will start celebrating with drink. You will have dinner here, then go home and celebrate with drinks. Because it very clearly says, there are some conditions saying that if you are meeting the condition, then you are a TRP. My gut feeling says, after reading those rules, this has all come day before yesterday, right? My gut feel says that all of you are eligible to be a TRP. That is what the rule says. Now, first is that you will apply for enrollment, right? Then the concerned officer will check whether you are eligible. So what is the eligibility criteria? Quickly, I will just say, one is that, yes, you should have a degree. You should have passed some university. The minimum qualification is degree, BCom and equivalent, BBM and all those things is number one. Or if you are having, see, this is what I think you people have to get into it, right? Start discussing with your peers and see and seek more clarity so that, you know, you are on top of this. It's very, very important for all of you, right? So one, it says that if you have any such certification conducted by the concerned department, which means, you know, probably many of you will have this sales tax STPE certificate. So now you need to see whether that STPE certificate is valid or whether that certificate will be considered as your additional qualification. Okay, so these are some of the things. And the government has made fantastic retirement plan for all the governors, government officials. Every government official above the B, what is it, B? They have the position, na? B division. What is it? B grade. Okay, whatever it says something. So every officer, no, every sales tax officer above the B group, okay, can become a TRP. But two important conditions that you need to know, that if you want to be a TRP, you should be of sound mind. And number two is this, you should not have any criminal record, right? So then you are eligible to become a TRP. So one, you have this application, then the eligibility for becoming a TRP is verified, right? And the correctness of the return and everything will be okay. One good news. It's not really a good news, right? Section 34 of the current GST law says very clearly, even though TRP is acting on your behalf and filing your return and all those things, right? The correctness of the return filed by the TRP, the liability is not on TRP, it is going to be on the taxpayer. Clap odithira. Right? So this is one maybe icing on the cake. Then once it is accepted, you will get an SMS or email, confirmation. So once you have filed the return, basically, once you have filed the return for your thing, then the taxpayer is going to get the thing. So how this filing happens, we will just discuss. I think there is a slide on that. Then you will affix your the digital signature and all those things, right? Have we covered that part? The portal accepting the form. Okay. TRP, what are the things that you can do as a TRP? See, being recognized, or once you have been certified as a TRP under GST, what is that you can do? One is that, you know, you can furnish the detail of the outward and inward supply. Then you can furnish your monthly, quarterly, annual and final return. You can make payment for into the electronic credit ledger. Okay, now one important thing that I forgot to mention earlier is that, you know, if you see in GST, you have something called electronic credit ledger and electronic cash ledger. This concept would be something new for VAT dealers, but then for excise dealers, it is already there. You have something called, under excise, what do you have? PLA ledger, right, which acts like your bank passbook. So similarly, now under GST, for every dealer, there is going to be an electronic credit ledger, there is going to be an electronic cash ledger, and that will get automatically updated, and they will maintain your bank account, bank balance on the portal of yours. Another problem is that now you have to start reconciling with your client's book. What he's showing is whether it is being reflected there. Just see, in every step, right, your workload is going to increase. So what are your plans? How are you going to now start being preparing for this magnitude of change that is going to happen? You can file claim for refund. You can represent taxable person other than inspection, search, seizure and arrest. Very good, na? Naale our client bandi heltaru yenri nanga arrest madak bandidare elri ni hogu, where are you hiding? Hey, law na helta idare nan yenri madadu nim hogri amel nodana, right? And you can now file appeal in the first appellate authority and the appellate tribunal. You can file as a TRP. Audit report, only chartered accountant and cost accountant who are holding the certificate of practice only can sign the audit report, which is 9B, right? 9B, right? You can file an application for fresh registration, for amendment or for cancellation of registration. These are the things as a TRP that you can do. Okay, these are your 7 forms. Okay, and the first is the TRP 1 is basically your application. TRP 2 is enrollment. TRP 3, if you are not, you know, following the rules and regulations for all those things, then they will say that I am going to terminate your certificate. So you need to give a show cause notice, right? Which is this TRP 3. Then TRP 4 is going to be the order of cancelling the enrollment as a tax return preparer. So you gave a show cause notice, the concerned officer is not satisfied with it. In TRP 4, he is going to now cancel your registration. Now TRP 5 is going to give you the list of tax return preparers who have been certified. TRP 6 is going to be the consent that the taxpayer. Now this, if you see, if you just imagine, it is this, what the way the rule is specified, it looks like this whole process of authorizing and all those things is similarly like the your income tax, where you have your auditor. Okay, auditor detail is available to you, and then your client is going to now accept and say that, okay, this is going to be my auditor, and then the auditor also was going to accept and say that, yes, this I am accepting is as my client. So similar kind of the system is what looks like will be made available under this thing. So six is what is that I as a taxpayer, I am going to now say, yes, you are my, I am going to select it and then say you are going to be my TRP. Now as a TRP, you will have to acknowledge it. Okay. And he is not happy with your service. Okay, TRP 7, he can say, I am not happy with my tax consultant, my auditor, I am changing him. He can change you. Then you will get one SMS saying that you have been removed. Okay, so this is what is your thing. Please go through this. Okay, luckily these are the only forms which are very small, half a page, one page and one and a half page. So very easily you can finish reading tonight.